chromatography introduction. You are watching this lecture on my YouTube channel, Dr. Biochem Lectures. My name is Dr. Alam Zeb. I am a professor at the Department of Biochemistry, University of Malacan. First, we need to know what is chromatography. Chromatography is a separation technique. It can be defined as the separation of a mixture by a distribution of its components between a mobile phase and a stationary phase over time. So this is the detailed definition. Another definition is it is a technique, a separation technique, in which a mixture is separated into its components. So the chroma means color. So this was the originally, we go to the history. Invention of the chromatography started by the Tweed in 1903 by separating the plant pigments on a chalk column, and then partition and paper chromatography use were invented in 1940s, and then liquid partition chromatography were reported by Martin and Senge in 1941, and development of ion exchange chromatography and the amino acid analyzer during the 1950, invention of gel filtration chromatography in the late 1950s. In order to go a little bit more detail, by 1958, Morstein and Speckmann reported the automatic analysis of amino acid samples by means of ion exchange chromatography. Similarly, gel filtration chromatography technique was developed in 1950s, the same time, and then the 1965 instrumental LC were developed by Waters, and then significant development occur later on. Now, what are the purposes of chromatographies? There are two main type of the chromatography. The first one is analytical. This purpose is to determine chemical composition of a sample. The second purpose is the preparative one. This is carried out to purify and collect one or more component of the sample. So these two are the main purpose of the. Now, what are the components of the chromatography? As we mentioned in the definition, there are two main components. The first one, mobile phase. This phase is used to separate mixture. It may be either gas or a liquid phase, so it can vary. The second component is the stationary phase. This phase is the phase on which mixture is separated. It is called the stationary phase. It is usually a solid or a liquid, the paper or the column, etc. Now, how it is carried out? This chromatographic technique is carried out. You can see in this figure, the sample in the first one is the sample is eluted with the passage of time, and then you see the molecule separation occur, the blue and the red one, and then the separation occur in the third column, and then the fourth column. You can see from the left, the red component is separated, and then the fourth one and the last one is, you can see the blue component is separated. So in this way you can separate the mixture. This is a simple concept. Application of chromatography. There are several applications of chromatography. The first one is the chemical and biological science laboratories. In chemical and biological science laboratories, chromatographic techniques are widely used, not only one type, but around all of them are widely used. Starting from the simple chromatographic techniques to the higher advanced level. The second application is in the pharmaceutical industries. In the pharmaceutical industries, we use to synthesize drugs, and we determine the amount of each chemical found in the new products, and we determine its different properties as well as the purity using the different chromatography techniques. The third one is the application in medical or in hospitals, or simply you can say the medical application. Chromatography is used to detect blood or alcohol level in a patient blood stream, disease of cell morphology, similarly hemoglobin and other blood components can be determined using chromatography techniques. The most important one is also the fourth one, which is the forensic analysis. In forensic science, we use we compare a sample that we collect from the crime scene and compare it with the samples from the possible suspects, and then we determine the crime, the who is basically the responsible of the particular crime and the culprits. The fifth is also the very important one. It is food analysis, or in the food industry. In this case, we study the chemical components of the food, the different type of food, the plant food, the animal food, and thus they are widely used in food industries. For example, we determine the components of these different food, whether the plants or animals. The sixth application is the environment in environmental science. So you can see in environment, starting from industrial pollution to the plants science, we did use chromatography. The seventh one is in the chemical industry. In chemical industry, we synthesize the new compound, just like in the pharmaceutical industry, but in this case, we determine the purity, and then we determine the structure, and we determine other properties. So in the chemical industry, chromatography is a basic technique which is used for doing these functions.